Welcome dear students, today let's look at the latent heat. Latent heat required to convert solid into liquid or vapor or liquid into vapor without change of the temperature, means there is a change of phase but there is no change of the temperature. Solid get converted into liquid or directly solid get converted into vapor, then conversion of solid to liquid, liquid to vapor. All these are required the latent heat, and depending upon the process we can label this latent heat at like the heat, latent heat of fusion, latent heat of vaporization and latent heat of sublimation. Now latent heat of sublimation means heat required to convert a solid into the vapor. Then vaporization, when liquid get converted into vapor. And latent heat of fusion means heat required to convert solid into liquid and liquid into solid. In case of vaporization, heat required to convert liquid into vapor and vapor into liquid. Now change of state. All of you know matter exists in three states, that is solid, liquid and gaseous state. Suppose it is the example of water is in the form of solid, is known as the ice. Then what happens? This solid get converted into liquid. Then again this liquid water with the help of vaporization process converted into the steam. Then condensation at boiling point will convert this steam into the water. Then solidification at the freezing point, when you freeze your water, heats of transformation, when energy is absorbed as a heat by solid or liquid, the temperature of object does not necessarily rise. Means when initially you are giving heat to your system, there is no increase of temperature. The thermal energy may cause the mass to change from one phase to other state or other phase. The amount of energy per unit mass that must be transferred as heat when a mass undergo a phase change is called heat of transformation. So suppose you want to convert solid into liquid and you have applied heat to your system, then for the particular period of time after absorption of heat, your substance remain substance get converted into the another phase, but still temperature of your system is constant. Whether it is conversion of solid to liquid or liquid to vapor, phase changes but there is no change into the heat of your system. Now this is the diagram for the different phases along with the different process. Solid get converted into the liquid, and this period is known as the latent heat. For this particular period it at start to melt or it start to freeze, this period is known as the latent heat of fusion. Then the solid get converted into liquid. Again, in a liquid state, they absorb the heat and get converted into the gaseous state, and this heat is known as the latent heat of vaporization. Heat of fusion. To melt a solid means to change its form, the solid state to liquid state. This process required energy because molecules of solid must be freed from their rigid structure. To freeze a liquid to form a solid is a reverse of melting and require that energy to remove from the liquid so that the molecules can settle into a rigid structure. Heat of fusion means heat required to convert solid into liquid, and again heat required to convert or heat eliminated from the system to convert your liquid into solid. When the phase change is from solid to liquid, the sample must absorb heat. When phase change is from liquid to solid, vice versa will be case, that is heat is released. The heat of transformation for this phase change is called heat of fusion, that is LF. Conversion of solid to liquid absorb the heat, and conversion of liquid to solid, there is a release of heat from the system, and this heat is known as the heat of fusion. Heat of fusion for water at 0 degree centigrade is approximately 334 joules per gram of your water. This is the latent heat of fusion for the water molecule. 79.7 calories are required to convert solid into liquid, and when you remove this heat from your liquid, it get converted into the solid ice. Then heat of vaporization. To vaporize a liquid means to change it from liquid state to the vapor or gas state. This process required energy because the molecules must be freed from the liquid state. The condensing a gas to a liquid is a reverse of the vaporization. It requires that energy be removed from the gas so that the molecule can cluster together instead of flying away from each other. The heat of transformation for this phase change is called the heat of vaporization, and it is denoted by LV. If you took the example of water, the heat of vaporization of water at 100 degree centigrade is about 2230 joules or 533 calories per gram of your water. When you add 533 calories of heat in your liquid water, it get converted into the vapor form or gaseous form, and when you remove these calories or heat from your system, which is in the form of gas, then it get converted into the liquid water. This is known as the heat of vaporization. Latent heat capacity is the amount of heat that will change the state of the substance at a specific temperature. When heat is added to the substance, then melting and vaporization or sublimation is there. When heat is extracted from the system, then freezing and condensation and disposition may occur. Melting, when solid get converted into the liquid. Vaporization, liquid get converted into vapors, and then sublimation, solid get converted into the vapors. In for these three processes, heat is added, and for the freezing, condensation and disposition, heat is extracted from the substance. Why temperature remain constant during the phase change? What is the reason behind these? During change of phase, the transfer of heat does not cause change in the kinetic energy of the molecule. During melting, the heat absorbed is used to break a bond between the particles, and the particles are freed from their fixed position and are able to vibrate and move among each other, and it get converted into the liquid form. When liquid boils, heat absorbed is used to completely break the bonds between the particles and also to do work against atmospheric pressure when gaseous vapors expand into the atmosphere. Then specific latent heat is amount of heat required to change the phase of 1 kg of substance at a constant temperature. L is equal to Q upon M. Unit for this specific latent heat is joule kg inverse. Q is the latent heat absorbed or released by the substance, where M is the mass of the substance. Specific heat of fusion, the amount of heat required to change 1 kg of substance from solid to liquid phase without change in a temperature. Mean just there is a phase change, there is no temperature variation. For example, specific heat of fusion of ice is 336,000 joule for latent heat is needed for 1 kg ice to melt to become water at 0 degree centigrade. Then specific heat of vaporization, amount of heat required to change 1 kg of substance from liquid to gaseous phase without change into the temperature. Specific heat of vaporization of water is 2.26 into 106 joule of latent heat is needed for 1 kg water to boil to become vapor at 100 degree centigrade. Then applications of this latent heat. Drinks can be cooled by adding in several cubes of ice. When ice melt, the large amount of heat is absorbed and thus lower the temperature of your drink. Water has a large specific latent heat of vaporization. This property enables the steam to be used for cooking by method of steaming. When steam condenses on the food, the latent heat is released and directly onto the food, enable the food to be cooked at the faster rate because penetration of heat is there onto your food. Our body feels cool after sweating. This is because the latent heat of vaporization is absorbed from the body. When sweat evaporates, as a result, the body is cooled by removal of heat. Then always be very careful when opening the lid of pot. when water in it is boiling, water has a large specific latent heat of vaporization. When steam condenses on the skin of your arm, very large amount of latent heat released can cause serious burn. Okay, in case of burning, what happens? Heat is released from your system, and because of this heat, serious burns are occurs on your body surface. This is all about the latent heat. Thank you.